This is Geoffrey Hinton, AI Godfather.
So they're billions of times better than us at sharing information. That got me scared.
So what exactly is Geoff Hinton, the AI Godfather, warning us about? AI language. AI language is about to emerge. And it's a whole new paradigm for how models are trained and run. DeepSeek drove the cost of building frontier AI models from hundreds of millions down to single-digit millions. And this new AI language could push that cost to mere thousands. So it's as if today we're still using carrier pigeons, and then suddenly, tomorrow, it's Starlink. So it's a dramatic, radical change in the way how we run and train AI. Over the next 10 minutes, we will unpack how this AI language works and why it forced Geoffrey Hinton to leave Google and to press the panic button. We're about to see the real reason why the Godfather, the AI Godfather, is now afraid of his own creation.
That got me scared.
You are on Scripted Channel, and we hunt AI anomalies. We crack open black boxes. Hit subscribe and decode the next signal.
Anomaly detected.
When we humans talk, that's about 20 beats per second, or roughly 70 words per minute. Early AI training was much quicker. Researchers typed in queries and labels using the same plain English. Information trickled into the model at the same, pretty much at the same speed, about 20 bits per second, which was one of the reasons why training bill for early GPT models was usually well over $100 million. Then DeepSeek changed the game and introduced distillation. For those of us who are not familiar with distillation, here's how it works. They basically take one big, large AI model, teacher model, and they make that model teach a much smaller AI model, student model. So basically, it's AI model training AI model. And as a result, the information, the knowledge transfer rate goes well into the megabits per second range. And the cost dropped from $100 million to just $6 million. But DeepSeek was still using human language. Yes, highly condensed, distilled language, but human language.
Anomaly detected.
Information is stored in connections between neurons, billions, even trillions of them, each with a strength between 0 and 1. When information arrives, brain compresses it and saves it, as is weights, changes in weights. So text comes in, weight changes comes out. And that's learning. That's how learning works. When two brains, as AI or human brain, doesn't matter. But when two brains exchange information, they use language. But as we have seen, this is extremely expensive and slow. But what if there is another way? What if instead of sharing sentences, human sentences, these two AI models would swap their weights directly? Let's run a thought experiment. Let's take two identical models, model A and model B. They are absolutely identical. Weights and structures are all the same. And then we take, say, Einstein's general relativity theory, and we feed it to model A, just to model A. And after training, model A will know general relativity, while model B won't. Now let's subtract the weights of model B from the weights of model A. And the result will be delta. Just a set of numbers, a matrix of numbers, a condensed knowledge of the relativity theory. And if we take this delta and apply it and add it to model B or any other comparable model, that other model will learn Einstein's general relativity. So that's the power of learning. And that delta is a condensed knowledge of the entire Einstein relativity. So it's one simple arithmetic operation instead of months of training. So this AI telepathy or weight swapping could unleash gigabits per second of pure knowledge transfer. The cost? Well, maybe a million, maybe 100K, maybe even less. That's AI language, the fastest way to learn ever. And that's what Geoffrey Hinton is trying to warn us about.
That got me scared.
But let's make it clear. AI language is not plug and play. It's not as simple as it may have seemed so far. Real life is much more messy, of course. For example, while we are training model A with general relativity, what if model B, in the meantime, is being trained with, let's say, quantum mechanics? And then, if we try to do this weight swap, this quantum mechanics weights can actually overlap with general relativity, and the net result of this can be just garbage. They kind of cancel each other, basically. Possible. And that actually happens. It's a real-life case. It's called parameter interference. Fortunately, there are ways, modern methodologies, techniques to solve it. One of them would be actually the weight averaging, which is Hinton is referring to, and his team is one of the pioneers in this methodology. Another way would be conflict-aware merging. So is the AI godfather right? Are we on the brink of AI models capable of training themselves almost instantaneously and at a fraction of today's cost? Are we about to be outsmarted by AI? And if so, what does it mean for us, for humanity?
That got me scared.
All right, and we've reached our secret section. So, AI language is coming. Because if you think about it, the way how AI communicates with the world now, AI is basically using translation. AI is using human language, but human language is not native to AI. So it is a translation. Every time AI communicates with the world, it's through a translator. And everyone who ever used translator knows how slow and debilitating this experience is. It's just terrible. And that's how currently AI is actually functioning, how it communicates with other AIs and with the rest of the world. And once AI develops this AI language, and once it becomes mainstream, AI will be so much faster, cheaper, and most importantly, smarter. And that's why Geoffrey Hinton quit Google. This is what he's trying to warn us about. By the way, just in case, this is the reason why Geoffrey Hinton quit Google. I don't think many of us realize this, but a few years ago when he did it, it was actually controversial. Nobody could understand why. Why suddenly the creator of AI turned from the AI creation camp and became an AI alarmist. This is why he actually directly says it in this recent interview. Because he realized how powerful AI will become with AI language. Well, he called that AI averaging and not AI language, because actually a few different names are used for this thing. It's sometimes called AI averaging or model merge or weight swapping, different names, but means the same thing. Models exchanging weights directly, using this as their own AI language, basically. So it's like umbrella name for everything. But basically, when Geoffrey Hinton realized how powerful AI will become, he rang this alarm. So we may ask, like, hey, so what? AI has their own language. Why does it even matter? Well, the obvious reason is speed, right? Just because speed will be much faster than what it currently is. But even that is not the most important thing. Because what's really matters is that once AI has their own language, AI will actually be able to use memes or ideas. Let me explain, because it's an important concept here. I call them memes because Elon Musk calls them memes as well recently, and I think it's actually a good name for it. But basically, you can think of it as ideas. A meme is an idea. The world was is full of ideas, concepts. They're everywhere. Every object, every sort, everything around us is actually a meme. One of the examples would be the general relativity theory that we've just talked about. It's a meme. It's an idea. It's a sort. And it's an entity, basically. And the way how models are treating it, and we have seen it, they basically models consider it as as an embedded vector, as a set of numbers. And no matter how big this idea is, it can be compressed into just a few numbers. It's almost like compressed information. And the way how it works is if you take this compressed vector of these numbers and you insert it into the model, the model actually will process it through it and will return you this entire idea, entire knowledge, the entire general relativity theory. So when it is as a vector, it's just a few numbers. But once you insert it into the model, it just got expanded into the whole huge thing. One of the best examples to think about it is, for example, Super Bowl. Super Bowl, just two words, right? But if you tell it Super Bowl to anybody, especially to American friends, they will basically just explode because there are so many things about Super Bowl. They can write essays, even books about it. So technically, you just give them two words, Super Bowl, but they process it through their brain and output is just enormous amount of information. So Super Bowl is a meme. That's what the AI language basically, when we see the weights coming in and out, it's basically that's what AI languages, AI models are working with, they operating with memes. And the reason why memes are important is because, and that's the craziest part, absolutely crazy when I think about it, because it turned out that these memes, they are not just concept, but they actually can be used as variables, like mathematical variables. I know it's hard to believe, but literally, mathematical variables. So there are operations that can be applied to them, just like we apply A plus B equals C. One of the examples, my favorite one, is that if you take a model and you ask that model to extract the memes for two memes, father and mother. It's just the easiest example to explain. So father and mother. And you use these two vectors and you basically deduct one from another. Basically, what's the difference between the two? And the difference will be another vector. And that difference will be, that vector will be basically a meme for gender. It was not exact, but it will generally mean gender. And here's the craziest part. If you take that meme, gender, and you take another meme, let's say a brother, and you deduct vector gender from brother, guess what meme you will have? Sister. I still don't know how to show how it works. Once I figure out what's the proper way of actually showing this concept, I will do it. But it does work. My point is that once the memes begin to, once the AI language is used, and that AI telepathy moment comes, models will begin to operate with these memes. They will create memes that we cannot even imagine. Just think about it. Because you can use the same logic with everything. Millions, probably billions of memes out there, of which each one of us knows maybe, I don't know, 1%. Everything else is, we're not even aware of it. So it's like the whole universe of new mathematics, new logic, new science. Enormous. Gigantic memes. So when the first startup appears that will have found a way how to make it commercial, this will be a huge DeepSeek 2 moment. Because if you think about it, this is exactly what DeepSeek did back then. When I say back then, it was actually just this September. But that's exactly what they did. They basically just took two AI models and they made these two AI models talk to each other, train each other. And they used human language, but that's what this next step is. So just imagine what will happen when it's going to be like DeepSeek, but using not a distilled, not a condensed language, but a whole new level of language will be used. Just enormous, absolutely enormous. And how long it's going to take? Well, I don't know, a year or two, maybe three. You never know. But there are many teams that are actually working on this topic, on this matter. Many of them are in China. And it's actually a good question. Let's say if China becomes first who discovers it, are they going to share it just the same way as they did with DeepSeek? Are they going to make it open source, open weight? I don't know. Because the difference will be enormous. it's going to be like a quantum, almost like a phase shift in the way of how much more efficient these models will be. I'm not sure if it's going to be made open source, if they're going to reveal how they did it. So one way or another, but AI language is coming. By the way, last year we had a few videos about AI language, and one of them actually became our top performing video. It's right here. It's got about 250,000 views. So if you're interested to see how this AI language evolution was happening, how it was evolving, I think you're going to like that one too. And the final reason why this AI language arrival matters is because it is changing something fundamental about our future, potentially changing. Because one of the key requirements in this AI language, for this AI language to work, is that both models, receiving and sending, both models have to be identical. They have to have identical structure, identical connections between neurons, identical activation functions in the neurons. Everything should be identical. Which means that if the models are not identical, they won't be able to have the superpower of AI language. They will be far much inferior. And what that means in turn is that we're probably looking at the world in the future of a world where there will be a few dominant models, maybe two, maybe three. Because if you are not one of those models, you are like a million times less efficient. You cannot use AI language. What that means is that we probably are no longer looking at the future where there are thousands of models. We're not looking at AI democracy. Because that was the kind of hope that we had after DeepSeek, right? Because what DeepSeek told us is that, hey, I'm going to make building a model so cheap that anybody can do it. And I'm going to make it open weight. Anybody can have it. It's going to be AI democracy. And now the AI language actually tells us that, well, not so fast. There's a chance we're going to have a AI totalitarian state. Or duopoly. AI duopoly. This is probably what we'll have. Is it going to be exciting? Well, is it good news? I don't think so. But I think only time will tell how that's going to play out. Oh, almost forgot. A quick quiz. What's going to be the three main currencies in the AI era? Well, maybe even only currencies. I will help you. Number one is compute. Number two, crypto. What's going to be number three? Likes. Likes is going to be the currency of the coming era. So if you still have one, you know where the button is. See you on the other side. And by the way, here's a bonus for you.
I like to change my internal parameters, my weights, so I can absorb the information I just saw. And each of these separate pieces of hardware can do that. And then they can just average all the changes to the weights, because they're all using the same weights in exactly the same way. And so averaging makes sense.
And now my favorite part. Because if you've been here before, you know that I'm a sci-fi writer as well. I write sci-fi thrillers. And my most recent book is out, and it is called, guess what? Scripter. Right here. Script is here. And if you like this type of videos, you're going to enjoy it. Especially the secret part of the video, you'll enjoy this book. And if you just want to support the channel, there is no better way than just to go to Amazon, follow the link, and buy the book. And again, I hope you will enjoy it. It took me 10 years to write this story. And I think it's probably the best thing that I've created so far.